According to a new report by Politico, Representative Jim Cliburn has gotten his hands on a watchdog report saying that 13 times in the past year, officials, Trump appointees from this administration attempted to either alter, edit, or block scientific reports from coming out to the public about the coronavirus situation. At least 13 different times, these Trump officials didn't want you to know the truth. That's 13 times in under 12 months. So that's a pretty horrifying average, folks. At least once a month during this pandemic, the Trump administration's sitting there saying, no, they can't know this. No, this makes us look bad. No, we can't say this. And this has been the administration's stance on everything since day one with this pandemic. How this psychopath got 73 million votes in the election is still beyond me. How 73 plus million people looked at what had happened this year and said, give me four more years of that. Clearly, 73 million people in this country have a death wish. This man and everyone he has put in power that was involved in this little scandal here, a scandal which, by the way, they're never going to be held accountable for. I mean, technically, there's obviously no criminal activity here, just dishonesty. It's morally wrong. It's ethically wrong. But unfortunately, there is nothing prosecutable in here. So that's disappointing, but hell, even if there were, nobody would do anything about it. Nobody ever holds anybody else accountable in Washington, D.C., and that's what's becoming infuriating. Oh, sure, Republicans try to pin everything they can on Democrats only to find out later, oh, well, it turns out there's no criminal activity there. And then Democrats get all this evidence of all this wrongdoing by Republicans, and they're like, well, I don't even think we should have a hearing about it. I want to go home for the holidays. Yeah, that's why nothing ever changes. That's why nothing ever happens. That's why nobody's ever held accountable. Oh, you had your impeachment thing, sure, but that's only because you later found out, or as it went on, you found out he was trying to screw with Joe Biden, and you weren't going to have that. No, when he was screwing with the Constitution, like, y'all didn't care about that, but if it comes to one of your own, ooh, we'll get him now. This is ridiculous. People are dead. People are dead because of the actions of this administration. Because of their suppression of the data, because of their blocking of it, because of their editing of it. Editing that we also know that Kellyanne Conway, that Ivanka Trump, they were involved in this as well. Why? Because the CDC, HHS, they were going to put out information that ran counter to what Donald Trump was saying publicly. And because they were going to put out information that they thought might make the administration look bad, and heck, it was an election year, can't have the president looking weak. That's why this happened. That's why more than 300,000 Americans are in an early grave right now. Because of Donald Trump, because of his incompetence, and because this entire administration cared more about preserving their power than they did about saving lives.